Well, first of all, I think the president did the right thing and issued an executive order to deal with the unemployment insurance problem. This is extremely important in a time of high unemployment. And the problem we had was that the federal additional payment on top of regular unemployment insurance expired last week, and the Democrats seem to be unwilling to fix that unless we give them a whole lot of other things completely unrelated to the coronavirus. For example, they're pushing for a tax cut for wealthy people in New York and California. So the president actually took the initiative here. I hope that will get us back to the table with the president, chief of staff, and the secretary of the treasury sitting down with the Democrats, who in the end have to reach an agreement if we're going to get an outcome here. So we desperately need an outcome. The country is suffering through this pandemic. We all know it's not going to go away until we get a vaccine, and no one expects a vaccine before later this year or early next year. As you can imagine, I'm often asked by people, what can I do? I think the single most important thing it can do is wear a mask and practice social distancing and try to prevent the spread, because we clearly had a resurgence in Kentucky and in other states around the country. So this thing is going to be with us. We can't shut the economy down again. Even Dr. Fauci said we can't shut the economy down again. So we have to live with it. And the best way to live with it responsibly is to wear a mask and practice social distancing. Now, your question was about, will there be a next rescue package? I hope so. The environment is much more political and partisan now than it was back in March and April when we came together to pass the CARES Act, which, for example, for Pike County provided about $22 million, $19 million for the hospital, and $1.5 million for University of Pikeville. We do need another round. It's about time for schools to begin, and we think there needs to be additional money for K through 12 and for colleges and universities. We think there needs to be new money for the popular PPP program for small businesses. 48,000 Kentucky small businesses took advantage of those to the tune of $5.2 billion pumped in to our small businesses. And hospitals need more as well. And we need liability protection to protect doctors and nurses and hospitals and universities and K through 12 from being the subject of frivolous lawsuits during the coronavirus period. All of that has a great sense of urgency about it. And I'm hoping that'll bring the Democrats back to the table. They seem to have walked away, but I hope that'll bring them back to the table and we'll get an outcome for the American people. Well, they aren't talking yesterday and today. I just got off the phone with the administration folks, the Secretary Mnuchin and Chief of Staff Mark Meadows were on the phone with all of my members, all the Republican conference members, and we're hoping that the talks resume. There has been a bit of a stalemate the last few days. Well, there are some big differences. For example, additional assistance for state and local government. Your viewers would be interested to know that of the money we already sent down to Kentucky government, almost $2 billion, only 6% of it's been spent. And yet the Democrats in Washington are asking for another trillion dollars for state and local government. We think that completely unrelated to the emergency we're facing. So there's some big differences. The American people are tired of the haggling, and they'd like to see us come together and get an outcome. I would like to see us come together and get an outcome. But I think the effort ought to be directly related to the coronavirus pandemic that we're all struggling to get through. Well, I think the Secretary of the Treasury has already explained how that match could be met. with other federal money. So I don't want to get in an argument with the governor, but we simply see it differently. I think the governor can use it. I hope he will, because this unemployment need is present right now, because the extra federal payment on top of basic unemployment insurance expired last week. So I hope the governor will take another look at that and find a way to make it work. I think we all should. I mean, I try to be a good example myself. With Senate, after a brief period of being shut down like the whole country, went back into session May the 1st. We've been in session continuously. We've all been wearing our masks. We've been practicing social distancing. We've been able to work safely and successfully. And we're trying to provide a good example for everybody else in the country.